Hello and welcome back to Star Trek Birth of the Federation. And when we last left off, we started our adventures with the Klingon Empire, building it from scratch essentially. And although we made quite a bit of progress considering the size of the map, for some reason we have failed to make contact with any of the other major empires up to this point, even though it should have occurred at this stage, and it beats me why it hasn't. But well, I think our little adventure with the crystalline entity actually ensured that we have a little bit of more information as to where they could be, because this thing eliminated a generic colony over here someplace, along with three minor races in Toto. I mean, they could still be there and be coming as we speak, but I doubt it, to be honest, because these random event creatures, they only move on after every single living soul in the system has been eradicated, and along with some of the planets in case of the Borg. But well, we can expand in this area, which was one of our possible avenues for expansion anyhow. And I have also upgraded the DXWnd, which comes bundled with the all-in-one installer from a Motherfleet Command, because this version was very old, dating back to 2017, and as a result it may have been the cause for some of the problems we've been experiencing. And my hope is that the newer version will result in a more stable gameplay, you know, because restarting the game does not seem like a major thing on the surface, but it really takes me out of the immersion. And but hopefully that's something that can be avoided. And as a refresher for myself, we are assembling our little fleet here with a couple of light and heavy warships, guarding the unfortunately stable wormhole to the other side of the galaxy, which is something we could use actually. We could build another troop transporter and use this as a leapfrog position here, then to investigate what's near this particular one. Actually, well, it may be worth diverting some resources, but for now we are still a little slow on the ground, and our research has certainly made some progress, but not as fast as I would like it to be, since the Klingon Empire isn't so good on the technology front, but maybe we can manage. And we also wanted to build a... yeah, actually, what are we doing over here? Ah, I remember now, this thing is on a little adventure over here, exploring the couple of sectors we have unlocked, thanks to the latest advances in the, I think it was the propulsion technology, which gave us two or three more tiles of range, okay? And that's something we can keep in mind, certainly. And well, scanning range is a little bit of a problem, as you can see, all across our borders, since we only have the heavy cruiser right now with a scan range of more than one, which is why we are relying on star bases and subspace scanners primarily. And even so, we have wormholes and nebulas and neutral stars around here, and all of these are impacting our ability to keep tabs on our borders. And we also wanted to ensure that we can take over this cluster of systems here before the enemy does, or one of the major empires. And I'm quite sure we will have an enemy along the way, and also pretty soon, because our second nemesis is actually the Ferengi Alliance of all things, and of course the Romulans as usual. And pitting ourselves against another major empire with access to cloak ships is a little bit of a tall order, but against the Ferengi it should be quite manageable, assuming they cannot form a large doomsday or two to just rush us down with their cheap and rather disposable ships. But you know, numbers and all that, quality takes backseat to quantity. Yeah, so okay, first things first though, I should just see what we were up to last. Yeah, that was the crystalline entity, which will prey to our starbase of all things, yeah, along with the assault transporter, I believe. Actually, we could use this thing on the other side of the wormhole if we want to, and we certainly have a couple of ships providing support. Yeah, so three Bird of Praise and one heavy cruiser. And we have more ships incoming, so it's actually not a terrible idea. Maybe do this right away. Yeah, well, and then we can investigate what's over there. And otherwise, we need a couple of colony ships at the very least. So this could be a very strong cluster formed around Solaris, probably. So we need one troop transport at minimum, and then a couple of... okay. Oh, wait, we investigate this first and see what we can make happen here. So this is probably... okay, then we let this finish, and afterwards we build a couple of... on second thought, we should probably go with that mining prison, since it does offer 50% a bonus to industry sector-wide, and we can offset the moral penalty by building one of the unique buildings have available in our empire, the Great Hall, and as you can see, this is very important. We need to keep this powered at all times, and plus one morale empire-wide allows us to build mining prisons everywhere, essentially. It only requires that we have a dilithium source, and that means we can couple this with a shipyard most of the time. And yeah, bunker networks are good and all, along with the foot replicators, but it's not really a requirement until we have a main contact with another empire and are at war. But we should invest in some orbital batteries as soon as possible. And even though we do have a great ground combat strength thanks to being blood warriors and all, it could always be better. And if you can soften up the invading fleets, there would be a pretty large advantage in most of the battles, because these prioritize these troop transports, if I do recall correctly. So alright, I think we go to the mining prison first, and we actually... Oh wow, this thing is pretty pricey, and I want to invest in some ships instead, so maybe you can put this on the back burner for now. It should recover eventually, even if we let the money prison leave this running for a couple of turns while we invest our money in ships. And yeah, we should also upgrade our foundries, and this is something we could do. Yeah, maybe not right now, because it's quite pricey, you know, 9,720 credits, and we only make like a pitiful amount here per turn, so I don't think that would be the wise decision right now. But on the other hand, we need at least 3 colony ships right away, and afterwards we probably squeeze out another... actually, we can build at least buy ships someplace else, that's not a problem, so for now we just stick up with the foundry, I believe. And otherwise, speaking of ships, we could build a couple more someplace. Maybe we can even make this a little easier here to see with the overlays. Population system bonuses. I don't think there's a way to overlay shipyards in this title. Yeah, I don't think there is, so we just have to keep tracks of that manually. And I think we have one shipyard over here in the sector with the dilithium source. Maybe just we used one here to extend our range, makes sense. So, I guess we just see what we can find on the other side of the map. We can always abandon building the starbase. It will not use up our SO transporter, by the way. Okay, actually, to speed this process up a little bit, we should just swing over here with one of our with the remaining troop transport, I believe, by avoiding this anomaly over there, ideally. And it doesn't need to be escorted by now, and then someone else can swing over there. Probably this rather cheap bird of prey, and they can do some exploration here, but probably not find anything, if I had to guess. Alright, then we converge on the other position, and then we escort our troop transport to the other side of the galaxy. And hopefully we make contact with someone, but at least, yeah, hopefully not the Romulans for that matter. Yeah, because they also have a pretty strong intelligence arm, and at the moment we have barely any internal security, like 45, which is almost nothing. Yeah, almost. Alright, let's check that we are building things everywhere. Appears to be the case, so that's good. And we wanted to make the system into one of our research centers. Yeah, hopefully this can be done in short order. Afterwards we upgrade them right away. Yeah, that heavy cruiser, fantastic. And we should uncloak here, because if we make the cloaked and normal vessels in a fight, the enemy can only take shots at the one they can see, you know. This would be the troop transport in this case, which is not ideal. And also we have access to the second variety of the Bird of Prey now, which means it has a speed of 2 per turn and not just 1, so it's more suited to exploration, of course. Yeah, put all of these ships in here, we just form one big formation together with the heavy Bird of Prey, and at least that's a little dangled over here, but thus far the star bases have dealt with the threat we ran into, so hopefully this can be continue here. One more Bird of Prey for exploration purposes, I suppose. And we have another rather mediocre star system here. Well, that's fantastic, I suppose.
Combat will be avoided.
Over there, do your exploration stuff, please. Okay, everyone, into the wormhole, and off we go.
Task force will enter wormhole.
So, and we also have to keep an eye on research, of course, and keep this balanced out at all times. Right now, for instance, so we're looking at 4 over here and 8 over there, and sometimes this changes per technology level for whatever reason, even though we do not have any specific buildings boosting one of these departments here, so we do parsing sometimes. Okay, then bump this up to 18. Same over here. Okay, then... there we go. Yeah, let's see. We should have some idea of what's going on here, but even with the pitiful scanner we have right now, so... Wow, one troop transport here, it takes a long time to build anything.
Starbase under
construction.
Like
15 turns, but we can start on this eventually. And then we can use this as a stepping stone, hopefully. So, this is a very good system, yeah. We have one massive class M planet along with an equally large one, oceanic one. And that's well within reach for our troop transports and also our colony ships. So, maybe we'll take a little detour here from the usual construction schedule. And build one right away. Actually, do we need more than one? That's good, something we... okay. These are also worth grabbing, so we queue up a couple of colony ships and just purchase them manually. So very good, discovery. Yeah, extremely good. So Dilithium, well, we can grab this later, I suppose. And how far do we want to go here? I think this system should be suitable for now, even though it's a little too close to the other starbase. So I think we take this other one, even though it's not as productive, probably. Even when fully terraformed, that we can finish the job in this system as well and also take care of this here, which we only colonize for the shipyard, I believe. So we could build our starbase around the wormhole, Deep Space Nine style. And what are we looking at here? So undiscovered still, but actually there's nothing over there. Interesting. Sometimes it's a little hard to tell with the overlay which sectors you've been visited there, yes. Yeah, so it's a little probably okay, makes sense. As I've mentioned, it's an old and clunky game. nothing can be done about it, I'm afraid. Okay, build this thing here finally.
Acknowledged.
And anything else we can spot over there? Apparently not. Oh, there's another part of the nebula here, just empty void. Yeah, we can only buy two. Yeah, it's a little sad. And we're short on the lithium anyway, which means this will be put on hold probably. Alright, which one would you colonize first? I think we go for this one first here. Yeah, it looks very juicy to me. And afterwards we can fortify this in some fashion. And we also need more ships. Let's not forget about that. And we have another rather impressive looking class M planet. It's just a shame that it is placed in such a lackluster system. We don't even get any bonuses here. Yeah. Okay. Our shooters can be pickers, right? Eight, so it's evening out, which is good. Get to work, please, or brave warriors.
Starbase under construction.
And well, apparently there's nothing going on here as far as we can see, but it's very close to the map edge, but there can still be a couple of systems out here thanks to the random seed we're using in this galaxy. I think for now we just provide some protection for our colony ship, but I don't think there will be anyone over here. It seems very unlikely. We've already seen them. And our scanners, if nothing else.
Purchase acknowledged.
And yeah, now we go for this one probably. I mean, the system. The elements also isn't bad for a shipyard or something. It's okay, now we can hopefully, apparently we can, but then we abandon this attempt for now and just double check with our resources so we have plenty of food. And I think we still need one more hunting ground, so that's something we can free up via brief.
Purchase acknowledged.
And then we wanted to, what do we want to do system actually? So we have a shipyard here, but it's only as an emergency measure. And we cannot back this up with a dilithium refinery because there isn't any source here in the system. Bunker network, well, it's pretty cheap. Maybe a subspace scanner. Yeah, as you can see, this is owned by our empire, but we cannot see anything thanks to the rather lackluster scan properties of the starbase. Since it's not our focus of the empire, you know, technology and all that. So I think we go with that after we have built a wind turbine to provide power. Of course we already built this, makes sense. So then we need to invest a couple of rounds here in the matter furnace, at least 3 or so. Okay then. Should be fairly good, I think. And afterwards, I guess we just build a couple of security centers here, maybe 10 or so in total. at least have some internal security other than our main planet, which only has, I think, 3 or so of these buildings in total. Yeah, exactly 3. So it does not offer any resistance whatsoever, as you would imagine. You're busy. Our colony ships are inbound, and that's double checking to be so nothing on the scanners. And with only one heavy cruiser over there, we wouldn't be able to see anyone really. It comes down to the scan range. It really has an impact on the probability to detect even uncloaked ships, as we've learned here over here with that random event monster. Even though we do have 10 scan range and the starbase nearby, it was still hidden. Yeah. Which is why I sometimes like to play the Federation. They are really good. Makes it really easy to patrol the borders, especially with the science cruiser you can unlock later on. Are we there yet? Apparently not. I think it's so slow.
Select terraforming target.
Perfect, yeah, that's because of the mining prison we built. Okay, get this thing out of the queue, and afterwards, yeah, we really need to build this great wall here after we've upgraded our foundries. But this is too expensive, we cannot buy this or purchase this outright. It's too bad. Another colony ship, never wanted to swing it over here. Yeah, fantastic. So you get to work, you have arrived in your location, and then we also need to
select terraforming target.
Also need to uncloak the other ships here. Systems are going fine, yes. Okay, we should double check this manually once in a while just to make sure that everything is going according to schedule. So we are making some progress here, but the growth rate is not as good as it could be, but I think it should get off the ground eventually. And we have colonized this fairly recently, I believe, since we've only built one hunting ground here, apparently. Okay then. This was one of our industry systems, at least supposed to be. Actually, no, we've queued up a couple of economies. Okay, I'll wait 20, but we still need some power in the sector, so we need to build at least one or two meta furnaces here just in case. Yeah, orbital batteries, you don't need a whole lot of them, according to, yeah, depending on tech level, but at least 2 or 3 should be suitable for most of the important systems. And if you build this into a research center, it would certainly qualify as one. Okay, we're upgrading the foundries, and then we can invest most of our workforce here already, as far as I can tell. Okay, and once again, we need some power in this sector. Yeah, we can build this everywhere, so it is not really a problem. Yeah, mining prison and the system as well. It should even out with the Great Hall of Warriors, I hope. And yeah, some delivery would also be great. And we should fortify this sooner than later. The starbase helps out, of course, but it only does so much. And yeah, this is only one. Yeah, we should probably dispatch one colony ship here just to, yeah, because it's a little sad here. Even it's only for the shipyard, we can do more with the system. You know, a couple of security centers will go a long way. Yeah, but okay, we let this finish, then we go over here probably, since the starbase is still under construction outside of colony ship range anyway. Okay, another research center. And this fully maxed out in terms of population anyhow, so that's good. And then we can, we let this upgrade here first, I believe this should be good. Subspace scanner. And we don't have enough food for the entire population, so we have to queue up a couple more of those, I'm afraid. Maybe 5, and then we build a couple more foundries. I mean, yeah, 10 should be plentiful, and afterwards we can probably squeeze in a couple of security centers. But with our economy being this weak, we should not divert too much attention to internal security and research. We really need this high populous count, high productive industrial sectors. At least 5 or so in total, at least in this stage of the campaign. I know that much already from experience, from playing the game, even the vanilla version. Okay then.
Select terraforming target.
The troop transport can help out with terraforming, but not the other way around. Can we do? And yeah, I think
purchase
we should.
Acknowledged.
Hopefully upgrading the foundry doesn't take too long. I think we help out over here some players. I mean, this is not terrible and we have done good work already. But Largo can wait for later, I'm sure. Yeah, very, very slowly, especially the Arctic planets. I mean, you could colonize first and then have a second ship come in later to finish the job, but really, it doesn't give you as much of a head start, especially with our resources being stretched this thin. I think it's better doing this way. Okay, another problem here with research, apparently. Actually, that was the wrong way. Pardon me. In case you're wondering, the soundtrack is different for every Empire, and it's also dynamically assembled. It comes with a couple of small snippets, and they are assembled at random, but they're still seamless, so that's quite impressive how this works, you know, especially for a game this old. And I think the audio quality is also quite nice in terms of sampling. And I've also extracted this for myself as a custom playlist just to listen to it once in a while. And I think the total runtime of every track, you know, once assembled, is about 10 to 15 minutes per Empire. Quite nice, I have to say. Especially the Klingon soundtrack, though. I like the ominous drums in the background. And they are 61, so it's only, I think, 8 or 7% per turn. Yeah, it's really slow going.
Terraforming completed.
We don't have anyone to trade with, unfortunately, but it would really help out with our bottom line. I think we can just, in the new games, we would be able to just double click on this, but apparently not here. Yeah, old and clunky.
Select terraforming target.
Old and clunky.
Select terraforming target.
And they need more hunting grounds, of course, once we terraform the rest of the plants in the system. I mean, it's not a whole lot. I mean, it's 15 populace here, 0.1. Okay, well, I guess we just do it. It's already colonized in all. No sense of letting it get to waste.
Select terraforming target.
We need more warships eventually, and this is, this is a long ways off here.
Terraforming completed. Select terraforming target. Select terraforming target.
I want to get this foundry progress here going, but it's really so expensive.
Terraforming completed.
I think this works double clicking, so that's good. And we have another mining prison here underway, and then we can decide what else we want to put in here. Maybe some of these. Yeah, we don't want to stack this with the forced labor farm. Yeah, not ideal, but maybe we can build the replicator. I mean, depends. You can see. So. Yeah, I mean, it could probably not be enough. I mean, once we have researched the next tech level, that would be a different story, but we need some metaphors before we can do anything else in the system anyway. We are only powering the shipyard, more or less. And that should have a pretty substantial impact, probably cut us in half. Pretty good. I like it. It's not something the Federation has access to, of course.
Select terraforming target.
They like to play nice with the minor races or subjugated systems, and if you do this, the populace will be really, really unhappy about this. Yeah, I think it's minus 10.
Select terraforming target. Terraforming completed.
So with the Federation, you would be looking at a peaceful expansion for the most part.
Select terraforming target.
Or the fighting wars when it's absolutely necessary, but something you can avoid in this
title,
you know.
Select terraforming target.
So you have to start blasting things eventually. Yeah, fantastic. So 67.
Terraforming completed.
And it's one of the rather unfortunate random events, and of course it hits at our home system. Yeah, of all things. Okay, well, we can at least check what the mining prison has accomplished when it comes to the shipbuilding times. And I think it took off at least 3 or 4 turns here. Okay, the lithium, it's really not good. Yeah, really it's not, so I think we unstuff the security centers for now, put them in the industry. Also really need this going here. Of course now we have a surplus here in food. Man, these poor fellows would take only a couple of turns to get back to full pop camp here, but still a little bit of a roadblock we didn't need.
Select terraforming target. Starbase completed. Terraforming completed.
Terraforming completed. I think it was the starbase on the wormhole on the other side that we can get going to investigating, you know, what's on the border over there. And if we decide to hide it out of here, we can just abandon the starbase or just scrap it.
Select terraforming target.
It's expensive to maintain, and we don't have to do this at all times if we don't need to. Ideally, I would like to leave it, you know, and use it as another power base. So, okay, nothing on the scanners here, even with the combined might of our starbase and the, heavy cruisers. I mean, we have two in total. Okay, I think we keep them in one big cluster here and just split them out and see what we can find. Everything else should be good. And one system, okay. And we have to at least take away this heavy bird of prey here because it only has medium range. If we want to venture further out. Replicators, yeah, I think it's only one turn, so it should be fine. What else? Yeah, we need to get upgrading here when it comes to our foundries, or just queue up a couple of colony ships right away. And I think we should do this afterwards, invest in a couple of ships. But we can decide later. First things first, some power. And another uninhabited system, really? Okay, then we just leave that thing behind for now. It seems sketch to me.
Terraforming completed.
Nothing? Really? No one? I mean, we have uncovered 40% or so of the map already. It's really strange. Really is very strange.
Select terraforming target. Select terraforming target. Starbase completed. Terraforming completed.
Fantastic. Now we can discover one of the other systems. So I think this colony ship will be fine on its own. So we can head over there with our remaining board of preys. And then see what we can what we're looking at over here. So you go down this way, please. Another one over here. And let's not forget to cloak, since it's kind of crucial here. And the ships are not smart enough to avoid these dangerous anomalies, by the way. You have to babysit everyone. Yeah, like an away team, just on the galaxy-wide scale here.
Select terraforming target.
Alrighty then. We certainly have some systems here, and hopefully they're also owned.
Terraforming completed.
Nope. Nothing? Ah, so there is a ship, six ships even. And we can cheat a little bit here to just look at the stats. And as we can see, this is the minor race, the Akamarians. And these ships are actually not terrible at this stage of the campaign, thanks to our low tech level. So if we can sway them, that would be a good idea. But we cannot reach their home system right now anyway with our ships, so let's not worry about it. I mean, they will venture out and discover the surrounding area, but it would take a miracle to bump into them, you know, by accident. But okay, something to keep in mind. Maybe, yeah, the only option we're looking at is to colonize the system and then build a shipyard or build another troop transport and do something else with that. Yeah, we will see. Terraforming, yeah, you can double click and this is really annoying. And there's no hotkey, I mean there aren't any in the game really except to end your turn, I believe. Yeah. nothing in the way to speed up things here, I'm afraid.
Select terraforming target.
Here, I think range is okay, but we need to see our build tasks here at a glance, ideally. We keep this on. Don't have any defense except for the bunker, so... Alrighty. Security centers, okay.
An alien culture has been encountered.
Greetings from the United Federation of Planets. We come in peace, in the hope of an informative exchange of cultural and scientific knowledge. We look forward to diplomatic contact with your people.
Well, we will see about that.
Terraforming completed.
At least they wouldn't put a dagger in us at the first opportunity, since we're not their nemesis, you know, in this game mode, and they also focus on diplomacy, and at least in the TNG era, we should be allies, so I think there's a couple of bonuses, you know, the hidden ones, when it comes to our diplomacy, and I think we found them on the other side, is not correct? Yeah, so we bumped into Federation space with our ships. And this is actually colonized, so yeah, that's what the AI likes to do, just goes for these type planets and then just ignores the rest for most of the game. Okay, well, that's good for them, and that probably means they also have these guys under their influence right now. Alrighty then. Well, could have been worse, but now we need to put some internal security back on. Hopefully we can, thanks to the population growth having been bounded. And that should mean that should be automatically, no? Okay, yeah, we really need to do this here. Even against the Federation, they will put some espionage against us if necessary. Even if we are not at war. And it's a good way to ruin your relationships, by the way. Okay, the Foundry is only one turn off, which is fantastic. And yeah, 77 mobile points is not good enough. And then we put the damper on our factory output, and it's even stated here, so minus 23%, and then we do get the 50, of course, from the mining prison, and the plus 75 from the technology, I mean from the research tree. Okay, I think we need to focus on a couple of ships first before we upgrade our facilities here a little further. And we're way too far away to be threatened by anyone, apparently, and I don't think we can, actually, there was a way to check your strength versus the other ones, you know, but I think you need to invest some into intelligence. Because at the moment we don't have any idea of the strength or anything like this, I think. Empire status, actually, so it's a little bit of information. So they don't have any minor races at the moment, but they will still get to work on the Akamarians, I believe. Yeah, this is the overall morale of our empire. We should be content for us, but since we have one planet impacted by the mining prison, apparently that's enough to pull us down here just a little bit. And we have, I'm not sure what 2 and 10 means, but they have more systems, of course, since they focus on peaceful, what I meant to say here is that they have an easier time colonizing systems and terraforming them in the first place. So that actually, I think we have 2 dilithium refineries online, and the Federation have 7. So that's, I think, what we're looking at here. And of course, we have more systems with that resource inside. We just haven't bothered to build any refineries. And our economy is a little bit on the slower side, unsurprisingly. It's even the weakest in the game. And the same goes for science, of course. But the military is up to snuff. Yeah, so we can fight our way through this if we need to. But otherwise, yeah, probably not so much. Yeah, we cannot set up any trade routes, so what do we want to do here? Maybe we cannot really bribe them with our economy being this weak. But maybe they will offer us a non-aggression pact at some point, and that's something we may want to accept, even with the morale impact that we'll get from this, because the Klingons, they don't like peace treaties, you know. But if you can squeeze some money out of these trade routes, that would be justification enough in my book, and I'm the Chancellor here, and goddamn, they will do what I tell him to. This will be the most useful one for now, I think. Okay, let's not forget about terraforming. Because we don't want to lose progress here, even if it's only one turn. Don't have all the overlays active at all times, it makes it a little
select terraforming
confusing
target
to coordinate. So okay, you are done here, and then we can help out a little further.
Select
all
terraforming
here
target.
I mean, we terraformed all these planets, and even so, we've only gained another 5 million in the system over the course of 15 turns or so, and yeah, we don't have enough. Okay, that would be why they're starving already, but I think it was only this
purchase
turn here.
Acknowledged.
Okay. Building more ships someplace, I think it was in this system, or we were close to it. Okay, so yeah, we need to invest. Okay, free colony ships is alright, but afterwards we really have to focus on increasing our military might by building a couple of ships, and we should probably go with well, long-range ones in this case. I mean, we could just employ the medium ones for internal security measures because there can be discontent in the game, you know, systems rising up and declaring independence. It's more likely we subjugate the systems, of course, but it can happen regardless if you get, if you let get things out of hand. So, pretty decent thing here. I suppose we can couple this with a couple of heavy bird of preys. But we will decide later once the crew has been freed up. Move orders are important, of course.
Terraforming completed.
Four turns, I think we can live with that. So nothing over here, then we don't worry about it. I mean, we could investigate the borders, I'm sure, but over here seems to be more interesting right now. And these are probably also owned by the Federation of Will Be Soon, because it's the minor race, and we have one system with a pretty juicy oceanic planet. And I think we could compete for this if we want to, and we may be able to if we're fast enough, but I don't want to spread our empire too far out, and we have plenty of suitable systems on the other side of the map anyway. So I don't think it's the priority right now. I would rather colonize the systems here and get them off the ground,
which
will be slow going, no doubt, especially with our technology here. So anything else we learned with our ships over here? Apparently not. Well, then we can disconnect the
system. Will be colonized.
And this is almost done. I think it's two turns off. Okay. Anything else? I don't think I'm missing anything here. Okay, we can check what we get from this. Okay, I think it helped out. We have plenty of power here, thanks to the massive bonuses in the system. Yeah, so I think we just put a couple more factories and afterwards upgrade the entire bunch. Like 10 or so, that should be plenty for the rest of the campaign. And then hopefully we can also get rid of this morale penalty here, thanks to the Great Hall of Warriors.
At last, more breathing room.
Terraforming completed.
And one of the last
select terraforming target.
Well, being 50 million and 0.1 even. Okay, how much do we actually need here? Oh, 88, so at least 3 more,
crunches,
I believe.
Acknowledged.
So queue up a couple here and the rest should be fine done automatically, no problem. Colonized Selig, so very good growth rate, but not as good as it could be because there aren't too many plants in the system, unfortunately. And we also have to decide what we want to do with this, so another industrial base probably. Yeah, it should be fairly safe for outside of the reach of the other empires, assuming there isn't one right over here. Could also be, of course, you never know. It's still terraforming, should only be next turn here, that's fantastic. So, one thing else to do here, but hopefully, so 44. I don't think the agriculture center needs any power, so we can do this right away.
Purchase
and
acknowledged.
A bit of a padding here, just in case. The votes are right. 2 found ways, 2 hunting grounds, and we just let this all run automatically.
Terraforming completed. We have news from our diplomats.
Alright. 100 turns. Well, we need someone to fight, but it rather not be this the Federation, and we can also use the increase in diplomatic standing, even though our populace won't like it. I think it's a good idea, and we will need some money, we need some trade routes, and this is the first step in this relationship. We cannot offer a friendship treaty right away.
Treaty will be accepted.
I think it's a safe option, and they also brought a destroyer, so they're on the same tech level as we are, or roughly. And yeah, this thing is pretty good. It's a much better scan version than our board of praise, even though it's supposed to fill the same role, at least in the Balance of Power mod. And I think we, yes, we can colonize the system now. Hopefully, this will be quite a productive system.
Will be colonized.
Eventually. And yeah, we have a couple more unclaimed systems over here, so we should probably build some colony ships once we're able. Maybe back on Kronos, that would be swell. Disgruntled, yeah, so it's really not good, right? Every single build takes away our productivity here. I think it's this cumulative, probably is, right? So minus 35 already. Oh man, I mean, this is so expensive, I think we just have to bear the penalty here. And then afterwards invest in some ships, some colony ships ideally, so we crew up 5 for the time being, and the other system can focus on the military. I think it was Telebita, or however you pronounce this. Okay, well. Okay, what do we do for now, please? Yeah, but we know how large this beach is.
Breathing room.
Terraforming completed.
Yeah, see? Well, yeah, see, it took, actually we can check this right away in Kronos, but I think it's, 3 points of morale point, yeah, three or so, I think. Okay. And, so they are squeezed into this corner, which is good to know. So, once we have an alliance going, if it's even possible, they can make use of our wormhole, because the eye will also do this. If they feel safe enough to dispatch their ships. There could be a trap, of course. You just break the treaty when the ships are on the other side, relying on your star bases or your shipyards to view them. It's a little devious, but I think I don't want to exploit the item way. Okay, anything else we want to colonize here with our ship?
Select terraforming target.
We haven't even discovered the system yet, but it should occur next turn. And also pretty large bonus here in terms of. So maybe over here would be a good idea instead, since we have the star base going. And this is not a terrible system. Nader is this one, and we have a another source of delivery over here even too. And a very large plant just outside of range. Haseros is also pretty decent. We could colonize this right away, build a wind turbine, and then unlock the rest of this with the shipyard. Okay, convince me. I think we give it a try without, yeah, going near the neutron star ideally, yes. Okay, one more turn here. And actually we should investigate what their realm looks like in terms of expansion, so I think Sol will be over here someplace, if I had to guess, and they dispatch the destroyer tool to investigate what's going on. And there are 15 colonies that probably have terraformed every single system up to this point. Okay, makes sense, but we do not share any intelligence at the moment, so what we can see with our scanners, it does not equal to their information, no, what they have uncovered, except for these sectors for whatever reason. It's a little, this is a little odd, I have to say. I haven't seen this before, I don't think. This whole station here for now. So we have another colony ship here inside 2000. Alright, we have two class and planets. And a couple of minor ones. I mean, it's not terrible and it's very close nearby, so I guess we can just do this here brief. And finish up the trio here along with the starbase. And the other systems are actually. I guess we just. Yeah, foundries come first and then Kronos can pump out a couple of colony ships, that's fine. And should be improving eventually. Also, we can power it, of course. Yeah, that's the another thing here. So, I mean, we only have 3 security centers in total at the moment, at least staffed. I don't want to take away from research either, so I'm afraid if I have to come out of the industry sector here. Maybe once will be enough, alright. There we go. Very power intensive building, of course. Another good system to the south, relatively speaking. And yeah, I think we will expand first before we worry about the other systems that are closer by, but not as interesting or productive. Interesting. Maybe another couple of systems worth grabbing would also be a good idea. And also let's double check here, so because it is getting out of bag again, as you can see. Alrighty. The one. It usually wouldn't be this micromanagement intensive, but it's the classic 4X game for you without anything in the way of optimization, really. Okay, I think that should be fine though, just a bit of time.
An alien culture has been encountered.
The Antidians are too weak to travel in space. They are not even worthy to be our enemies.
Well, we would like to conquer something eventually, you know, so maybe that would be our first victim. And depending on
terraforming completed.
Yeah, depending on how far they have progressed here with the system, it should be fairly wimpy in terms of ground combat. And I think we can, yeah, there's an overlay, we can check this here. So they probably don't have any orbital batteries, if I had to guess. Actually, they do 9 already, so... now, on second thought, maybe we don't lose right away, but okay, these systems are very large, they're very productive. And, I'm not quite sure what they would give us in terms of unique buildings. So, actually, double check here. Alright. I'm not sure if this is a research building or something just producing food in the system. I mean, that's a good thing to happen, because then we can unstuff all of these hunting grounds, for instance, and dump all their populace in, I know, industry or something else, probably like that, yeah, together with a forced labor camp. I mean, it's not a terrible idea, but 9 orbital batteries and these minor races, they progress differently when it comes to their technology. These are not dependent on the overall galaxy-wide tech levels, if you want to put it that way. And 9 orbital batteries, and some of them may be powered, maybe not, we don't know. And we cannot find out without, unless we were to attack the system with our ships. And ground combat 5-10, I'm not quite sure how this compares to our rating, probably not a very favorable effect. To guess. I think that 300 something populous, yes. Okay, that should be equal to this roughly. Yeah, could you please show me the overlay? That would be slow. Yeah, this game is very clunky. Apparently, it doesn't want to. And I don't think we can do this from this particular screen. Yeah, it's not listed here, of course. Only industry output and so on and so forth. Yeah, there we go. It's just a problem with the starbase being in the same sector, I suppose. Beats me. Maybe it's events? Economic? Well, that makes sense to me. Ah, there we go. So we have, yeah, we have more than double the ground combat, I believe, or something that is alright. Well, then we cannot, or maybe we should actually, I'm not quite sure what our troop transport looks like in terms of combat prowess. I mean, we could check the object database, I suppose, and hope this doesn't crash the game, because it also happens from the screen, yeah. That's just lovely, at least in the original release it was the case. Maintenance cost, but there is a rating, it's hidden, but it should be accessible in some fashion, I believe, if we still have a troop transporter someplace, but I don't think this is the case, right? We used them up to build star bases. Well, that's too bad, and we just have to assume that we need at least 5 or 6 of those things to conquer the system. First try without suffering heavy attrition on our side. That will be a factor, and we need beefy starships with strong shields and heavy hulls to bear the brunt of the attack. You know, we cannot send in a fleet of tiny destroyers, you know, bird of prey. They wouldn't stand up to the orbital factories. Orbital factories, I mean the batteries, of course. If we had some production to spare, that would be a good idea, but I don't think we do at the moment. Maybe back on Kronos. I think we should be improving here eventually, so minus 30, I mean, okay, so having a, building which incurs a morale penalty in system without evening this out in some fashion is a bad idea in this game, you know, even though you wouldn't think that the impact would be this severe, but it really is. Okay, one colony, and we need some colony ships, that's the thing, you know, we need to expand. And this system is still busy here building these factories. Maybe we've reduced it slightly, and then we build a couple later here. Okay. I would really like to conquer this minor race here, but I don't think we will be able to. But we should probably get there before the Federation does. But if they haven't discovered the folks themselves, they won't know about them and start to influence them for that matter. Okay, actually we should check out this, and the other ship can take care of the other undiscovered ones. Okay, we are still doing this, and we have a colony ship incoming, and what do we want to do with this thing? So, this one system we wanted to take care of here brief for the shipyard, and then we can probably grab... This one looks quite good. I think we head for that first, avoiding, yeah, the neutron star here, the neutron star, because it will destroy our ship first try probably. And yeah, I kind of forgot about the system here, didn't I? And all the micromanagement, yeah, that was required by this game. I think we didn't buy this in the Astas far, so 61, I think, to all the bonuses, I should say. Okay, 61, and we need probably like 6 hunting grounds in total, so I think we build these first before we do anything else, and then here up a couple foundries here, 3 or so, also some meta furnaces, and I guess we could build this, actually, yeah, before we do this, actually, just build a wind turbine and a shipyard and see what we can find, and it offers more wind for exploration for our bird of place, if nothing else. Maybe even build a ship here, since it's much closer.
Terraforming completed.
Yeah, this is Gideon, actually. It's also quite important when it comes to making our decisions, of course. Yeah, Gideon Dirt is alright. So we're looking at 430 in total, and we could use another industrial output here, but I think we have this system for this purpose. But 330 is really good, to be honest. And we went for okay, security in the system. Another one over here, but probably just even out a little bit. So I think this will be an industrial base then. So we need at least a couple of furnaces to power the shipyard, which will be a requirement in the system, even though we don't have the lithium. That's okay. We can put the reprocessing plant in here if we want to. But it's really very expensive and there's no need with I guess we go with meta furnaces for now, since they are very cheap to buy. Also to build for that metal and shipyard, and afterwards we probably start building some factories. After we've taken okay off this, alright, it's a good idea, I think. And that doesn't really solve the problem though, but I think we need a couple more foundries, hunting grounds in this case. So no one starves here, that would be great. So we've arrived.
Select terraforming target. Purchase acknowledged.
I guess we leave them over there for one turn, and the other ships, have they seen anything with their sensors? I wouldn't think so, right? Yeah. Okay, power this thing here, and then we squeeze out depending on what we can see, maybe. Because we don't have any information, not even the scanner here, no starbase. I mean, this building a starbase would be a good idea. It would be the edge here of our extent of our reach here on this side on the map. I mean, it could be a good idea. You want to have some overlapping things here so you can retreat and consolidate your fleets, for instance, and have some repair at these strong points. I think it's not the worst of ideas, and we should be able to afford to buy one here outright, yeah.
Purchase acknowledged. Okay.
This is a system worth defending anyhow, very much so, even without a source of dilithium.
Select terraforming target.
And another uninhabited system for whatever reason. Out of reach here it would seem, but what else can we find here? That would be good to know. And we could certainly colonize a couple more systems over there. Most of which are undiscovered apparently. Okay, get to Monkey please.
Starbase under construction.
Yeah, I would really, really like to assemble a strike force to conquer that minor race, but if we misjudge our strength versus theirs, we could get wiped out, and it would be a substantial loss in industrial credit already invested. Something I want to do necessarily, so can we do anything else in terms of power? We haven't unlocked the charger that goes on Arctic planets yet, so we would have to rely on meta furnaces, which we cannot stuff right now. Okay, wow. I guess we build one just in case. Afterwards, we have to get some food on the ground here before people start to starve, which will occur pretty soon. Okay, then. Slow going. We can always pause the queue if you need to. Hopefully, 5 will be enough, thanks for the bonuses provided in the system. Do we bother to colonize? Or do we want to terraform first? Okay, another class and planet. I think that's also something we wanted to. Okay, I think we colonize right away and then get the shipyard ongoing.
System will be colonized.
Since we can build a wind turbine. in another colony ship. They can finish the job over here someplace. Yeah, should be good.
At last, more
terraforming completed.
It's also a very good system. And so they are escorting two transports to build a starbase in place along with a frigate, which is a ship unique to the Federation and this mod. And it does not have any photon torpedo launchers, it just relies on very accurate phaser banks and lots of them. So these are the bane of your existence when it comes to fighting against them, you know. It's certainly much better than our destroyers, it is really specialized on taking out these small and fast ships, most of which we have in our fleet right now. Yeah, okay, so I'm not quite sure what they're doing. Maybe they're heading to the system, but it should be outside of their vent still. I mean, it's something we need to grab at the earliest opportunity, so can we fly over there with a colony ship, by the way? I mean, we have one. Yeah, so... Okay, I think you have new orders, my friend.
Combat will be avoided.
So when this attempt right now, we can finish this with someone else. For instance, this here. We want to do. I think this is also
select terraforming target.
Yeah, then we are short here, one ship essentially, but we can build more at corners here or nearby. It's not a problem, but this is the so the game is on. We need to secure these juicy systems and just colonize this here, by the way.
System will be colonized.
Yeah. I think they're still busy here, so we cannot, right? Yeah, it's way too expensive. We just have to be patient and let this roll over naturally. Even do away here with some of the food production. But we don't need all the power right now anyway, so just mix this out and two turns is better than nothing. And yeah, a couple more colony ships please, and hopefully it's improving eventually, yes. So well, maybe 1% every couple of turns, which is not a speedy process of course. Okay. So we have a colony ship, but I don't want to go exploring with that thing ideally.
Purchase acknowledged.
Yeah, we need to colonize this first. Then we send another ship here, I think. Yeah, to finish the job for us. But we wait for the population to expand, or grow, I should say. Okay, well, maybe... But I don't have any idea, and the starbase doesn't automatically uncover this, even if it's within range for the scanners. Already.
Last. Fantastic. More breathing room.
And so far the game hasn't bugged out when it comes to the visual glitches, so I think it really was down to the ancient version of the DXWnd. And they've made lots and lots of progress over the years, you know, even though it's only a couple of years old at this point, it's still ancient by comparison. Okay, we just have to hold back here, I suppose. I mean, I guess I don't want to get this thing destroyed here by bumping into a black hole or something stupid like this. Okay. And let's get the ship here, please.
Purchase acknowledged.
Galaxy was, I think, on the, yeah, here, the starbase. And we're looking at a pretty solid location for a couple of, security buildings, perhaps. That could be a good idea, but we don't have any bonuses in terms of food production, so, well, we don't have a large populace to support you anyway, so it's not that terrible, is it? Very few though, it's quite good, but we don't worry about this, not the pressing need, instead we just put some food production in here. Okay, 88, so I think it should be good, especially after we have unlocked the next research tree here, the next tech level. Okay, let me do this for now. Maybe also some meta furnaces and we can leave the system running on its own for now. Okay, yeah, we're also getting started here on this finally, which is good. And this should fill up automatically. Have to babysit this all the time. And are they actually heading for the system? I think they would, right? Oh, what are they reinforcing? They cannot build another starbase on top of the wormhole. This is our thing right now, thankfully. And we should
our warriors will engage the enemy
quite aggressively. And the starbase can fend for itself, really, especially against a single frigate and a couple of unarmed ships. We will see what they do, maybe build a starbase right next door. I mean, that could be good for them, I suppose. Yeah, really strange though, they usually do not do this. Especially since we're not in war or that. Okay. And then I guess, but we don't get here, so 65. Well, there doesn't mean anything to do by now. And we don't want to specialize in anything particular in the system, so maybe we can do a mixture of light industry along with a couple of security center system, hall of learnings. Yeah, that would also think a good idea. You don't want to specialize in every single system, because if the enemy does conquer it or destroys a couple of buildings with their intelligence arm, you know, especially the Cardassians and the Romulans, could really leave you wanting, you know, for a little more variety, because then losing that one system was a crucial defeat in your book and hard to recover from. So that's something you want to diversify a little bit at the very least. Okay, we just get to start here on this, I suppose. A couple of factories, a couple of furnaces, so just so we can get a subspace scanner online. And apparently we lost line of sight on the... so must be over here someplace then. But this system we really want to take first opportunity, even if it's right on the border. And we should be able to enter this with our ship right now. Fantastic.
Task force will enter wormhole.
Nothing over here as far as we know. They're still colonizing or terraforming, I should say, and this thing is still on its way. I guess to speed up the process here, we squeeze our ship over here, even though it's a little bit of a risk, to be honest. Okay, and then hopefully we have access to this next turn, and the next colony ship is incoming to finish the job here when it comes to terraforming the systems. And we have another one under construction and another one finished. And where we want to dispatch this thing to. I mean, the system is also pretty decent once we have brought up to speed, even though the system, the plans aren't exactly the high productive ones. So Largo is still... system is making good ground here, I think. Yeah, two more should be good here. And then we can do this right away, build two furnaces. That should be good enough for a couple of buildings that we need, since we don't have the highest populous count here anyway. And there's no need to specialize in anything with only 200, I think, anyhow, right? Yeah. Just leave it as a generic system, I suppose. Three furnaces, and then we build a... I don't know, maybe a subspace scanner would be a good idea. Since we have this little blind spot and we don't want to have anything slip past here after the wormhole. Yeah. I mean, it shouldn't happen, but if they push through here with a large enough force, it will tear our starbase to shreds. Even though it is quite beefy, it cannot deal with all damage on its own.
Terraforming completed.
Site of phone, I think that was here, yes. Okay, the last system, or last planet in the system, and then I think instead of colony, actually should be though. We have another colony ship here, we can do this, alright. No problem then.
System will be colonized.
Nothing, just the empty void. Oh, then we just retreat to the wormhole here as a weapon response force, I suppose, even though it's only one ship. Everybody would like to know where the star base construction fleet went, because certainly not into the wormhole, they cannot do this. Right. We should probably colonize this right away just to speed up the process, but I don't want to swing around here with a second colony ship. So I think we just... okay, it's actually worthwhile though, so 65 isn't terrible. Yeah, certainly it's not, so we're looking at another 130. So I think it's okay, we should probably invest some time to terraform these first. And in terms of IC, yeah, they really don't like us. And Neutro is a little bit better, I think we got a couple of points, and this will improve over time, as long as the treaty is still in force.
At last!
So, once again, nothing over here whatsoever. But it's the map, actually, it doesn't matter really. Okay, and then we colonize this here right away.
System will be colonized.
Yeah, okay, this quantum still, can we please improve our relationship with the workforce finally? That would be great. And sometimes the overlay doesn't trigger, like, period. And you can also scrap buildings in case you're wondering. I think you do this from the structures menu, and you can scrap all of them if you want to, or just a single one, or all but one even, by holding down the shift key, I believe. I think that's how this works. No, I'm not quite sure why this doesn't show right now, but it can be good. We need this on par here, especially for constructing our military might, and yeah, I think I really want to go for conquering the minor race while we still can. And for this we need at least 5 assault transporters and a couple of heavy ships to absorb the damage. also target these orbital batteries, of course. So which ship would be most suitable for this task? Probably the heavy class cruiser here, I guess. These are probably the priciest ship we have in the arsenal right now, so could be a little bit of a miscalculation, but I think that's what we will go for. Here's the 5 assault transporters, and at least where we can take our other 2 heavy cruisers we have already built, so maybe 4 in total, along with a couple of battle cruisers. I think it should be good, and we don't need light ships for orbital bombardment. They would be easily destroyed, I think, at least from experience. Cypher 1000 should probably invest in a subspace scanner.
Purchase acknowledged.
At last! We have news from our diplomats.
That's good, but we can consider this later after we've taken care of all the other stuff here. And it's, for instance, building this subspace scanner.
Purchase acknowledged.
And powering it on. But I do think you have to agree to this in the same turn as it is offered. Yeah, I think that's how this works. So another, what do we want to do with this? I don't see any nearby star systems here.
Select terraforming target.
We have already picked up, that's good. There could be something over here, of course, but we don't know at the moment, so we just, this is not much in terms of production anyway, so it will be another mix system probably. And but we don't need the subspace scanner here, technically speaking, or nor do we need another shipyard, so I think we just get, training facilities only really useful in a system with a shipyard, because they then can just build some ships and have them train immediately. And if you have the same facility, in the same sector as the shipyard, they will gain one additional pip of experience automatically. Maybe even two, but I think, could be actually two for the Klingons, since they're so focused on a combat and all that. I don't remember. If it's something we should build on Kronos, on the, and the other industrial system we've already set up. Furnaces. Well, there isn't really anything to do here. The populace would be so. Okay, 45. So another 90 here, which is like kind of sad to be honest, alright? I think 3 hunting goals should fit the build, and we build 2 foundries, 2 meta furnaces, and then besides what we want to do with the rest of the workforce. Anything else here I'm missing? So we have another colony ship, so over there should be fine. Maybe this system could be good. Alright. I'll just colonize Largo already, could also be a good idea. And so can we discover this here, please? We need to find more planets to colonize, especially the juicier ones. And our friendship treaty, I think, do we have some systems available for trading? I think we do. So I think we should accept this. It's even indefinite. Hopefully we can at least forge an alliance
treaty
eventually.
Treaty will be accepted.
Yeah, we really need the money for our lackluster economy. Yeah, it's really that bad. So 45 here as well. 44, excuse me. Right. Not a very productive system either, but the 2 planets here are quite good, and even this is a very small system with very small planets, we still get a pretty substantial growth rate by comparison, thanks to this being class M planets. Yeah, we don't want to fight the Federation right now. It's not a good idea there, but hold your horses, we are already building our strike force here. Well, eventually we'll do this. But there's another melody here we didn't need, right? Can we finally check this, please? Because I really want to know. Apparently, it doesn't want to let me through. Well, that's nice of the game, I suppose. Nothing over here, like whatsoever. That's really puzzling. Must be the random seed then, of course. Alright, now we set up some trade routes, which we should be able to do by going to the economic screen. And then we have also access to their systems finally, what they are called, and we can also check them here. So they barely have invested any time or effort in terraforming all the planets, so they only went for the easy grabs here, which will put them at a severe disadvantage compared to our economy, even being it as lackluster as it is. So they focus on expansion first instead of doing it properly. But they have probably done so unknown, so that's something we could probably set up. And this is their home system, all the way in the back here. Good old Earth and Pluto and Saturn, yeah. And they do get a couple of bonuses, even though these planets are very tiny and would not support a populace this large here in the terms of this game. Yeah, so 410, no way you could get this in any other system, to be honest. Yeah, with the planets being this small. Yeah, most of them are even uninhabitable, you know. And I think in the balance of power mod, you do not get any gas giants in any system. No, the randomly generated ones is only fixed in Sol here, because in the original title, it was a little bit of a waste to have only one or two tiny barren planets, then a couple of these giant ones, and otherwise the system would have been completely useless. But that's a change I'm not completely approving of, to be honest. Okay, then we just... I think a corner should be good, and we can assign this to Sol. If we can find, I think this was the one here, so the overlaying of course, and it's down to 0 credits at the moment, but hopefully next turn we get at least the 100 or so, maybe 60, but also be great. And overlay here these system names, because they're like, kind of getting in the way, don't they? I know there's no fast way to do this. We unfortunately are not the AI. That would be much easier time, of course. And these tiny colonies with only one planet terraform, they don't offer much here in the way of trading, of course, or trading opportunities, I should say. But since you have so many planets here, or with a large enough populace already to support trading, just connect them, I suppose. At least the core colonies over there on the other side. And there's only one trade route per system, unless you were playing the Ferengi. They have two per, the major ones at the very least. So anything else we could accomplish right now with our systems? And I don't think there's anything else. No, you cannot check this in any fashion whatsoever, unfortunately. You have to do this all manually and also keep this updated. Also, yeah, keep track of this in your head. Alright, I think that should be good for now. And, yeah. Then we can check back here and see how much we got out of this, especially with Kronos and 43, well, it's not terrible. But by comparison, that would be a little less productive here since we went for this tiny colony due to lack of choice, but still a good boost here to our bottom line. And while we're outpacing our free ship support, but the population is already growing, so we don't have to worry about this, at least not at the time. Okay, we're building some security centers, which is good, yeah, very good. Extremely good even. Building Starbase and just terraforming it. Okay, so this is already queued up, just double checking so we don't neglect our new colonies. And it would be a little easier to do this from this, I suppose. Deep Space Scanner, 11 turns. Yeah, see, I almost forgot about him.
Select terraforming target.
Nothing to do here, we can't really explore. I suppose we could do this here, but we're nearby and it's almost impossible to see. Yeah, that's why I missed it before our other ship. But good thing we have another one in reserve. And there's the colony ship on left already. I think it was last turn. After I got distracted here. Okay.
Select terraforming target. Terraforming completed.
Yeah, no trade route, which should put to work right away. In the Clavator system, wherever that is. Over here, right? There we go. That doesn't really matter, there's no productivity in this arrangement at the moment.
Select terraforming target.
Yeah, our colony ship is kinda lost here, apparently, because there are no systems over there, like, period. The single one. That means there's no good use for our colony ship except to finish the job in Largo, I suppose. Okay, the first queue has finished, and this one of our earlier colonies actually right. So we can check what we can make happen here. That calls for probably a couple of matter furnaces, and then we can build our food replicator probably. So that's something we can do up here. I think three should be fine for now, and then also the all-important bunker network for later on. And yeah, we should build these orbital batteries sooner than later, but I don't think that will be quite doable in the system. Maybe on the later tech levels, yeah, so 5 security centers, I think we need more than that, I'm afraid. I think just upgrade our foundries just a little bit, and we can always cancel this later, or just buy it outright, since from 1 to 2 is not very expensive. Just the matter of industrial base or lack thereof in the system that makes the numbers not look particularly appealing.
Select terraforming target.
Nothing really. Well, it's the very web edge, but of course, as I've mentioned, that's not a guarantee. There's nothing over there thanks to the random seed. Yeah, but we need the income here from the trade wood, and I think I'll probably second just suck it up for now, if they're not at war with anyone. And I'm not quite sure if we can do anything with them. We can probably... Yeah, we could request money from someone, but I think only from the major powers, right? Yeah, I think that's how this works. So we can give them some money, I suppose, to sway their opinion of us, but we want to declare war on them essentially before the Federation gets over there to discover what's going on. Hopefully that's still easy pickings for us, relatively speaking, so they have not progressed to the next tech level at the very least. And it will be very slow going with our shipbuilding queue, yeah, back in Kronos. So probably do this in several systems at the same time to make this a little easier, and I think we can do this soonish, yeah. At least until beta here, so 4 turns, what we're looking at here, so... Oh... At least I'm not disgruntled anymore, but it's something. We also need a... Actually, we already have one. Huh. Okay, then we will use these both systems here to build ourselves some ships, since they are too expensive to buy outright, at least most of them are.
Terraforming completed. Select terraforming target. Select terraforming target. Select terraforming target.
There were all the systems, yes. Not the juicy one over there since it's a volcanic one right
now. Select terraforming target.
Well, set me up for this place. Any idle systems, because it's nothing you want to see here on the screen. I mean, after we've done the upgrades later on, and there's nothing to put except trade routes, it's a different story. For now, of course, we're kind of having our hands full, especially with the tech level. Which we should check, by the way, before I forget. 55, so it's already unbalanced again, which is just fantastic. Okay, I think we have to devote some attention. So they have colonized any further systems, so as they are just leaving them as is. I mean, it's kinda strange. The AI has different priorities, of course. And even the nearest colonies, the earliest ones, they only went for the easy stuff, really. Well, doesn't bode well for their chances in a war if they... well, that would also explain, of course, why the AI has a hard time here catching up for our expansion. But we have grabbed a couple of systems early on, some of the very juicy ones, so that gives us a head start, of course, given that our economy is pretty weak to begin with. And well, there's a black hole here, but thankfully the ship was not destroyed, so it's not a guaranteed thing, of course, but let's just head out of here before anything unfortunate happens. Oh, so a transporter, and then we get to start here on the first meta furnace. Afterwards, we can do something else with the system, hopefully. Okay, how much is this? So,
okay,
I think we swallowed the pill. Just upgrading the factories. Okay, 2. Yeah, we don't have that much cash, we have to keep an eye on that. So, there's nothing here really for our colony ship, not a single buffer target. Okay, anything else? Maybe. Okay, fully colonized, fully terraformed. Did a few source, but otherwise not terribly appealing. Okay, this could be a different story. It's actually not bad. I mean, all the things here, I think we go for that. Really wish we could free up this community already, but it's only one more turn. Afterwards, we can get started here on a couple of ships. Hopefully our little colony ship is also making some progress, but where the task force went over here, I really cannot tell. Ah, so they had grabbed this system, good for them. Wasn't particularly interested in volcanic planets anyway. Alright. Before I forget here. Okay, 2 more turns, I believe.
Terraforming completed.
Indeed. Good, we should set this up right away, the Gideon system. So where is that? Probably down here. Yeah, there we go. So, that's, and then what are we looking at here in terms of shipbuilding? So we have a couple of ships queued up already in Kronos, and we need more heavy support ships though. Okay, I think you will focus on some heavy cruisers. Like, if we just pump out some support ships, but we don't need them for a ground assault, that would be dead weight. These are very, very pricey as you can see, so I think we just focus on a couple of better cruisers instead. They are a little more disposable. I mean, relatively speaking. And then we build two more assault transports, and whichever survives we can use for starbase construction is not a problem. Okay. I think it's too pricey to build outright. I mean, to buy outright, I should say. Okay, Largo, two more planets left.
Select terraforming target. Select terraforming target.
Every division you could just order your colony ships to terraform every single planet in the system and automatically colonize it, but yeah, this game is very old and very clunky as I've mentioned, so you just have to live without it, I suppose.
Select terraforming target.
Yeah, get these things here out of
purchase
the
pool
so we can get started on some proper ships. Oh, wait, what's going on with Clavier then? So we're up to 470 or close to it. I mean, yeah, I think we need to focus on food production first, unfortunately. So we need at least, yeah, I think we need six more hunting grounds right now, and afterwards we probably turn this into another industrial base, but there's Klavia actually. Maybe do something else with that. Maybe some research. Yeah, because we colonize everything inside, it makes it really hard to keep track of these things sometimes, I'm sorry. Ah, whatever, doesn't matter, then we just, yeah, we have one system for intelligence gathering, then we have a couple for research, and well, this is also a prime system for industrial base. I think we go with that instead. Also, to make it a little more bearable here, we build a couple of furnaces first for the food replicator and the inevitable star base and all that. Star shipyard, I should say. Okay, another thing is coming here. Then we have like 6 in total with the other system combined, and hopefully, this will be enough output. So, do we bother building more of those things? I think Battlecruiser.
Okay. Purchase acknowledged.
We have some money to spare here finally thanks to the intergalactic trade going on, so I think
purchase
we build this after all. Hopefully this should be good enough, no 5 in total. Did you hope that will be enough to do the trick? So everyone is just scooting around or terraforming, that's good. Can it work? Do we have enough food here? Of course we do not.
Terraforming completed. Purchase acknowledged.
And they're so cheap, you might as well buy them here while we can afford it. So, sorry for these ships, of course, these battleships, the proper ones, they are quite a bit more expensive.
Purchase acknowledged.
Head over there sooner than later before they reach the next tech level. That would make
select
it even
terraforming
harder,
target.
Not to crack. Just something we don't want, of course. I know you cannot queue up orders or something like this, you cannot even order the pathfinding, it's all automatic, and if they want to go suicidal here, you have to be the babysitters and then move them somewhere else and hope you don't forget. Yeah, it's that type of game. So another colony ship here.
Select
planet.
Terraforming target.
The cruisers are also only one speed at a time. Yeah, at least in this tech level hopefully you can. Well, it's getting there eventually, I suppose. Anything else going on over here? Probably not, right? Okay, you can get to work on the next system,
select
please.
Terraforming target. Terraforming completed.
Apparently, they have finished the starbase construction thanks to having 2 troop transports and also being a little more focused on this anyway. I think it takes them not as long compared to all ships. So, a good thing we have the starbase setup and the wormhole, right? Yeah, so enjoy that system here, that very light cluster one, but with the starbase nearby, it's still a very formidable thing to overcome with your ships. Because the starbases, they are a lot more durable in balance of power than they were in the base game, I believe. And they also had outposts back then, which were very easy and fast and quick to build. I think it was only 2 or 3 turns, but these were almost useless. They couldn't even stand up to 2 or 3 destroyers, yeah. A very wimpy task force, for all things considered, which is why they were removed in this mod. Something else I may not necessarily agree with, because sometimes you do need the additional scan range or something like this, you know, to make a little expansion, even if it's on the Jaeger side. But you don't have that option here, unfortunately. So, heavy cruiser that we cannot buy this, of course, so just have to be patient. Maybe this one though, maybe this one story. And then we do away with the rest of the assault transports, I think, or will 5 be enough though? Yeah, well, we'll see. I don't want a better opportunity, of course.
System will be colonized.
Especially not against the minor race. It's a little embarrassing.
At last!
Starbase completed. Terraforming completed.
Okay, terraforming completed. We have another battlecruiser we could purchase outright, hopefully, but apparently not. Well, that's too bad.
Select terraforming target. Select terraforming target.
I think we finished the starbase over here, which is good, thanks to the system here being quite important. Okay, terraforming still, and we have 6 turns to wait. It's 3 battle cruisers that we can take the rest of our heavy cruisers from over there. Okay, that means that maybe a large enough task force already. I wouldn't really count on it, to be honest. It's better to go in with overkill, especially against the minor race. It wouldn't be so bad against the Federation probably, and they don't have any orbital bases right now, or orbital batteries, or maybe they build a couple, so one only. That's all they can power probably, right? 9? Okay then.
Select terraforming target.
Now we could take the heavy bird of prey and the assault strike forces, and not necessarily a problem. It's a lot more durable than the basic bird of prey. And these guys, they can start heading to the wormhole, I suppose, since they're very slow. And there's nothing for them to do here anyway. Have enough food for everyone, that's good. Fantastic, yeah, then we get to build these things here finally. And upgrade the entire thing, hopefully they will be providing enough intelligence to actually fend off some espionage attempts by the Federation, but I think the AI is not as aggressive, especially against people they have friendship treaties with. So we don't have to be too concerned, I think, at least for the time being. I really wish our starbase would be able to tell us anything else, you know, then because it's where we don't know. And we have to still wait for this here to finish, right? Okay, Meta Furnace, this was a system we wanted to mix up things. Actually, just a Hall of Learning, okay, that makes sense. Wait. Take this down, build the cartridge center along with Bomber can be built here. Maybe the wind turbine and then the food replicators, and would free up another pip in terms of workforce, which I think it's a better idea to do something like this at the moment, and afterwards we probably upgrade our Hall of Learnings first. Halls of Learning, I should say. So there's another colony ship incoming. Probably making a grab for the system, yes. Nope. I mean, it's still 2 turns away. But they're going for the system, and I'm not allowing them this, yeah, absolutely not. Not a million years, friends, even though we have a friendship treaty. Oh, it's probably heading over here could also be the case. Well, we haven't discovered this yet, so we can do this with our heavy board of prey, since there's nothing better to do anyhow. Yeah, well. Devious little folks, thankfully I kept an eye on this very important system, but no doubt they would like to call in this as the first opportunity, of course. Same goes for us, of course.
Purchase acknowledged.
Way too pricey.
Terraforming completed.
And yeah, I think we take two more assault transports with us just to be on the safe side. And then there should be plenty though for one minor race, assuming we can get past the orbital batteries and maybe a mistake, maybe I will be reconsidering, but usually it's not that bad. But it's already turn 300 almost, which means they should be outpacing us in terms of technology, yeah, so maybe not the smartest of place after all, but we'll see. And we should be outpacing our free ship support plenty, yeah, so these battle cruisers, especially these heavy cruisers, they are quite pricey as you would imagine. Leave this here, and then what else do we want to do? So apparently we were focusing on internal security with this system. Rather we just queue up, I think, 10 or so, that should be plenty for. And we already have some meta furnaces, and we don't need the power really at the moment, so that's good. Engineer Hall of Learning, of course. Security centers, 10 should be plenty for the rest of the game, really. And yeah, they're certainly going for this, aren't they? As destroyer, so it's still incoming, I think. Yeah, so I think we just colonize this right away.
System will be colonized.
You know, I don't want to lose the system for under our noses, really. That would be very embarrassing. And then someone else, we have a wind turbine here, so we just build a star, a shipyard, and then build ourselves a colony ship. And then we can find something else over here, or just grab this thing while it's still available. And also be pretty close to the system we want to conquer. Could be a good idea, but they will have made diplomatic contact with this race already, I think. Yeah, so that's not good for us. We are pressed for time then. The Federation has a very easy time swaying these minor races, of course. Most of them, except for the Shellac, I suppose, and the other warrior race. The name escapes me right now, I'm sorry. The Battlecruiser. I think we already took care of that.
At last, more breathing room.
Yeah, very
exposed one. Terraforming completed.
Won't be the count on this holding out for much longer if the Womans are slightly to the north. Especially if we wreck our military trying to conquer this minor race, yeah.
System will be colonized. Select terraforming target.
So there's one system here, very lackluster one. Maybe we can take care of this if we run out of room to... that could also happen, of course. Thanks for the competition going on with the other empires.
Purchase acknowledged.
Things could get a little heated eventually, which would be nice. And yeah, we turned away the colony ship, of course. But it was heading for the system, that much I'm very much certain of. Okay, wind turbine.
Purchase acknowledged. Shipyard,
colony ship to finish off this batch here, and then we can also squeeze out some warships here if we absolutely have to. Yeah, it's so much for that, folks. And we should also build a troop transporter here just to build another starbase. But if someone survives the assault on Antande, we could just use this here, I suppose. Okay. Yeah, so much for that, folks. It was a very good system here. So good thing we beat the Federation to the punch. I don't think they will be particularly happy about this, but they just have to suck it up, I suppose. And they would have done the same to us, no doubt.
At last, terraforming completed.
And colonizing all the systems in short order will offset our problems here, as you can see. We are back to content all around, which is fantastic. I mean, almost, right? Apparently we're so disgruntled on Kronos, well, that's not good. But focus on one thing at a time here. And we have built another ship here, that's good. Especially the heavy cruiser, which you can also use for reconnaissance. Yeah, and it's of course later price, you have to be patient here.
Select terraforming target.
Largos is not a very good system, so we just leave this to its own devices here. Let's queue up a couple of facilities. Three more meta furnaces here, just to run things off, and afterwards, there's another system here actually, but it's not terrible, and there's no competition, so we can certainly go straight if we want to, otherwise we just support our, I know there's nothing to do here, so we just keep it on the frontier here, so to speak. Yeah. quite decent thus far. Pretty good start for us, despite our weak economy and all that. I have been very aggressive when it comes to our expansion. Extremely aggressive, and hopefully this thing will get lost here. Yeah. Be good. Can we do this right away? And I think I think we build the assault transporter first, and we didn't want the star base going, so we're not reliant on a single planet and a single structure and all that, and afterwards the colony ship, I suppose, and then get start on the usual assignment here. Okay. We also extend our borders, and then we have control of this entire thing, and they cannot squeeze us any further here, I suppose, and then hopefully we can also do this. Yeah, that would be a good idea, that we stop the Federation's expansion in the northern side of this sector. Yeah, would be really good, I think. So, another system here, wipe for further investigation. So, it's 470 again, where was that? Kalion. Yeah, it was here, so that's also on the frontier, and I think we're already building this into a... Kind of forgot here, maybe I should write this down to make a little, make some plans here, because you cannot add any nodes here in the menu, unfortunately. So, but we need a more industrial output, no question. But we also need internal security. We also need more resource, so... indeed, so where was it again? Cardion. It's probably not the system I was thinking about. I don't think you can jump to any particular system here with a hotkey. But I really don't know then. I just can't find it. I mean, we don't have that many colonies, but it beats me, to be honest, and we just go for industrial base. It seems to be the most suitable for the sector anyway, and we have plenty of food, so we don't have to worry about anything. Yeah, just queue up a couple of furnaces here for some orbital batteries, ideally. Maybe 5 should do the trick, and then we just dump all of our effort in some factories. I mean, could probably do 25 here almost, eventually it is, after all the tech upgrades, so we do just that. And then also build, actually we should probably build a mining post before we do anything else, right? But this is require... I think it requires a dilithium to be in the sector, so instead we go with a... Actually, it doesn't help us with industry, of course. Well, then never mind. Yeah, just build some meta furnaces and go back to the original plan. I don't need that anymore. So, just forget about it. So, we have another solar transporter waiting for us, and we have powered this thing, so hopefully it should give us a contingency plan in case something happens to our starbase. And another solar transporter. Okay, I don't think we can afford this right away. And just building here the heavy cruiser.
Terraforming completed.
Yeah, just something we need to buy. Bunker network, yeah, but being on the frontier, this would also be a good idea, but I don't think we have to worry about the Federation right now, it's not necessarily so. But we do need is more food, yeah, that much for certain, so we can start this here right away. And then if you have to pause the queue to purchase some ships, it doesn't really make a whole lot of sense when you think about it. Yeah, you can do this everywhere, essentially, so we have the spot of prey, which can stay behind, I suppose. Couple of heavy ships incoming, and then we have finished terraforming over here, which is good.
Select terraforming target.
And yeah, the system as well.
Select terraforming target.
Let's see what the Federation is up to, if anything. Ah, so yeah, that's why we have access to this now, thanks to the starbase. Okay, build this thing here, please.
Starbase under construction.
And you investigate this. I mean, we don't need to escort this necessarily, but we have to wait for other cycles to arrive, of course.
Terraforming completed. Select terraforming target.
If it's uninhabited, I might grab us right away, even if it's a lackluster one. The competition is on over here to the Federation, or against the Federation, I should say. Yeah, terraforming completed in the other side of the map here. So you cannot... over there, but I was clicking on it, which is a little annoying. Yeah, I think it was this system actually.
Select terraforming target.
And what else do we want to send over there? We don't really need anything necessarily, right? We have heavy cruisers, we have a couple of battle cruisers too. We could use another military, maybe even build a small strike force consisting of one heavy cruiser and six bird of prey, something like this. That could also be a good idea. A fast evading force across the border with a couple of opportunities for long range scanning, I mean, relatively speaking. And I think we could afford this, yeah, and I think we should. Like, so I think we can put 9 ships in one group and this will be evading one. And yeah, the heavy ship is not as suitable to this task, but we need the additional range and the fire support to center around if we run into opposition. So I think it will be the task for the system for the foreseeable future. Yeah, I would really like to buy this, but we can't. And we just spend all of our dough on the other side essentially. And the Federation cannot see these vessels at the moment, so we just leave them over here until we are ready and have assembled our strike force. I mean, if the other guys over here, the minor base, has advanced on attack tree, that could be a different story, but it can always be considered, of course.
Terraforming completed.
Ah, that didn't take long, did it? Ah, party's still ongoing. So this is another very good system. So once we are done here, we should probably take 2 turns. Okay, we cannot go down there because, wow, this is outside of range for this ship. And we get this actually already discovered, so that leaves us over here some place. And then we just move our ships and see what we can find. We'd have to defend the system. You cannot do this against the friendly force anyhow. They will just colonize the system anyway and then tell your ships to get out of here. Or they don't think they will be removed automatically from their borders. But the AI will get upset and yell at you with a communique. Telling you what the hell, essentially,
select
even though your ships
target.
Are already in that sector once you change hands there, you know.
Select terraforming target.
These heavy cruisers, man. So expensive. Turns aren't exactly instantaneous anymore, but it could be a lot worse, especially given that we are halfway done with this, relatively speaking. I mean, probably should last about 1,000 turns in total, and hopefully it won't slow down as much as in the original title, but I think it would have slowed the call already, given the Vita release. I played quite a bit back in the day, much to my frustration, but I was more patient back then, and waiting 5 minutes for a turn to process was something I was willing to do, yeah, not anymore, of course, so... Okay, we can do a little review here of our forces eventually, so we have one heavy cruiser, 4 battle cruisers, 7 assault transporters in total, and we have another ship on its way here, so I think we just leave them behind and just take the battle cruiser with us. I think it's a decent plan, and they can do whatever here, building the strike force, that waiting force. And we probably need another assault transporter down here, or maybe a colony ship or something like this, but something we leave for later. Since we have plenty of planets to exploit and we don't even have to reach over here, perhaps we should. Especially the larger ones here with the class and planet. Because later on we will be required to channel ships and nothing but ships, and it means we need all these systems here with the lithium crystals and then build a refinery and also defend them and fortify them with batteries and all that. So can we get this over with, please? Thank you.
Terraforming completed.
So, another ships, or 8 ships even. And we're looking at the Talarians with their, it's actually pretty decent. There would be more than a match for our light ships at the moment. And they're pretty cheap to operate, as you can see. It's another change implemented by the Balance of Power mod. So they're actually worth keeping. And the Talarians, I'm not quite sure, but you can avoid them for now. I'm more interested in subjugating this race already. And yeah, see, now we're up to 15 orbital batteries, which is not something we can tackle, I'm afraid. So we have been a little too late here, I'm afraid, yeah, so... But we can use our heavy ships for orbital bombardments and remove some of these batteries, but... we're looking at a pretty tough nut to crack, so we have to reconsider after all and just be content with these colonies we could build up eventually. Not good, of course. Well, really not good. So we can at least look in the system here and see what they're up to. I don't think this is a spacefaring race.
Select terraforming target.
Do we really have the force for this? I mean, our ships are very fragile, as you can see. Only 150 hit points and not very strong shields either. It's certainly compared to the Federation. I think these batteries will actually tear us to shreds. Yeah, I'm really very scared about them. Or scared of them, I should say. Yeah, indeed. And we cannot take a loss this crippling against a rather unimportant system. I don't think they even give us a bonus, you know, when it comes to one of their facilities, applying Empire-wide is only food production in one system. First things first, we get them in here and then we decide again.
Terraforming completed. We have news from our diplomats.
Got your Vido. 8,400? I know, we can't even afford this, to be honest. And you can just ignore it or decline the proposal and it has the same outcome, really. So you just have to suck it up, I suppose. There's no way I'm paying this, no. In a million years. Absolutely not. Some of these demands are quite outrageous, especially coming from the Ferengi. They sometimes demand 100,000 or even more, or something like this. It's really outrageous. Because this is a bug or whatever, but okay, I mean, would be fitting with their female or, you know, according to the lore. And these are our arch rivals anyway, other than the Romulans, and I'm looking forward to exterminating them actually. They're really annoying and yeah, okay, well, we'll see. Let's not get ahead of ourselves, we haven't even found their territory yet. I'm not sure why the AI is so slow to expand in this playthrough, usually they're not. They're most of the time they're actually faster than by Empire, no, under my control. Okay, then have we... What is they're doing? This is finished. Is the terraforming? Okay. Yeah, finally, first advance here. Hopefully the other also a little further off than I would like it to be. Keep this out a little bit here. Not sure if ignoring a demand is more insulting than declining it, but I don't think that's a difference here ultimately. Okay, we have 7 transports and they have, I'm not quite sure, they have ground combat raiding someplace and I'm not sure where we can see it. Yeah, actually there's a 135, yeah, so that should be plenty. Actually 144 should be paying a little more attention, but this has been a pretty long session anyhow, and I think once we've moved over the ships over there, I will take a break, but okay, let's see here, still waiting. So 5 so should be more than plenty, but I'm so worried about these orbital batteries that will probably tear us to shreds, yeah, even if the ships we have at our disposal right now. So I'm not quite sure if we can manage, to be honest. I really don't. By comparison, the Federation has maybe 1 or 2 in total, yeah, even in the home system or 7, okay. Alrighty then. Makes sense, we should also do this on our own, yeah. But that's why we haven't really discovered anyone who would be interested in exterminating us, I mean like the Cardassians or the Romulans. And yeah, we are in no position to threaten them with our intelligence services or even defend our empire, you know, with internal security. Might be the most realistic prospect at the time.
Select terraforming target.
We don't know if this would be enough. I mean, we have another battlecruiser and another heavy cruiser, and that may be good enough. So I actually we just sped up the. I know we didn't want to take this thing, of course. It was destined for our raiding force. Maybe if it survives, we can dispatch it later on, of course.
Purchase acknowledged.
Then we are looking at maybe 6 battle cruisers in total, a couple of heavy cruisers, along with a couple of support ships. I don't think that would be quite enough, but we cannot build like 30 ships in total. We don't have the industrial output or even the. Yeah, see, we are way over already. It's only the trade routes that keep us safe, and the Federation might decide to change their minds, yeah.
Select terraforming target.
So, we're off. The ships are useless and ground attacks. We just leave them behind here. They will just get destroyed. I mean, they can be cannon fodder for the orbital batteries, but I think they will always prioritize these assault transporters. And if we have to take part in the first wave of the attack, I think they will be destroyed outright instead of getting through. So we have to soften up the defenses, and that yeah, that could be quite could be quite difficult. So we have not even enough food in the sector, yeah, because we don't get any bonuses, even from the class and plant, which is not good. So we have to waste more time on this here, I'm afraid. Maybe once we have completed the next research assignments, our ships will become a little more powerful, upgrade automatically across the Empire, that would also be great. I'm not quite sure about the requirements at the moment, but it shouldn't take too long. And now our ships have to go to the Wombo anyway and assemble their little strike force. Yeah, listening post. Always good is to direct upgrade for the subspace scanner with longer range. The generator that is there for the home system, I believe, avoids additional damage. Comet testing center, yeah, that's
terraforming completed.
Something that boosts our weapon research if we were to build it someplace. Okay, we take the heavy cruiser with us if we really need it, and then we can crew up another one over here. Shouldn't be a problem. I mean, hopefully not. And terraforming also finished someplace. Yeah, probably here, right? No? Must be the system that we were trying to get from the Federation. Okay, we haven't unlocked any new ships yet, I suppose, but we can check the new facilities at the very least. And I think that's exclusive to. If you know, we can build this anywhere. It's just a matter of keeping it powered, but we do get also 1 plus morale. No, actually, 1 per Empire native system, since only our Kronos. Okay, can we power this at the moment? I mean, we could divert some workforce, I suppose, from the Eternal Security Centers finally. Yeah, I think we may as well do this since they're only class 2 right now. And then, do we have some vested here already? So, 900, I think we let this finish, and we built this thing because we could use the boost, of course. And also the morale bonus, and hopefully this will get us out of the disgruntled state here with our workforce. That would be swell. Yeah, would really be. Okay, we need 4 more turns to get over here. 7 assault transporters is a lot better than 5, yeah, I think so, at the very least. And let's check what's going on over here, probably nothing. Except for our terraforming efforts.
Select terraforming target.
Just a good thing, we cannot even see right now if there's the colony ship incoming, since we have terraformed one ship already. It could be possible that they already dispatched some. Yeah, so certainly something to keep in mind. We go, so we have the heavy cruiser 2 and the heavy bird of prey, fantastic. So that gives us a substantial boost to our ships, at least I hope so. And that's something that boosts research, and you can build in every sector, I believe. And technical college is probably
terraforming completed.
Yeah, so learning is good. Could use more hall of learnings here, by the way. Maybe power this here, and then we can see if this actually boosts this, if we can build in the sector, that would be better. So plus, we put this right away, I think, if we can power it, but we have plenty of power right now. And then, yeah, it's more important than worrying about foundry projects at the moment. We should build these subspace simulators everywhere, essentially, where we can afford it, since this applies empire-wide and it can really stack the bonuses. It could be quite important. So heavy bird of prey 2. I think it takes one turn for this to update. Maybe not. Okay, well, this is fantastic though. Very good. Just in time, essentially. I don't think we actually increased the speed, no. Well, that's too bad, because if there's something that we could use, it would be speedier ships. especially the warships. Yeah, the birds of prey are nice and all, and they're cloaked, but they're not very powerful.
Select terraforming
even
target.
In large groups, you would be hard-pressed to take down a battleship, even with superior tactics compared to the AI. As much as possible in this game. Okay, we're over the threshold in every single system. Okay, that's fantastic. Every single department,
terraforming
I should say.
Completed. Select terraforming target. Select terraforming target.
I mean, these aren't terrible. We could use this in ground assault. Yeah, but I think we will actually. Yeah, I think we should. Every single bit helps here, I guess. We need 15 already. That's very, very concerning. Yeah, wonderful. Is this not a new one? Yeah, indeed it is. Hopefully they won't start from this. Apparently not as good, but that's not good either, you know? We need this system up and running, especially that it's now on the frontier. And the battlecruiser we could take with us. Last one, so get over here please, another 4 turns.
Terraforming completed. Select terraforming target.
Almost the full group already, and that ship over here will finish off the job, I hope. One of the squadron. Then we head over there and see what we can find. Oh, great. Outcast, 30 hit points and 100 shield strength. Okay, but that can be deceiving. Sometimes they do have very powerful weapons. And at the moment, we are looking at what exactly. So we are keeping our colony ship safe, which is good. But the starbase is still under construction, and the troop transport is relatively helpless by comparison, so can we intercept this thing here before it does any damage? I mean, we could use the intercept command, of course. I don't think it would be particularly effective in this case. I mean, maybe we can try. Of course, intercept only works from own systems, makes sense. I mean, it's a pretty wimpy vessel, at least according by the stats over here, but it can be deceiving, as I've mentioned. And they could head for unfinished starbase, and this thing, I don't think, would be a match, you know. Well, 110 hit points and 275 strength is not terrible. And this takes too long to actually just one turn, since we have upgraded the ship, which is good. Well, then we try to intercept this thing here, I suppose. If we can. Because we're not sure where this thing is heading right now. And yeah, it does not work here, meeting them in between. I don't think it would, so. Obviously, it's not. I think it just spawned in, or maybe just spawned its own sensor since our coverage over here is a little lackluster, to say the least. It can only move one tile, but so. I think I'm worried about our star base. Actually, maybe we can split up into teams right now since we have these rather fast ships here to dispatch. And they can try to keep the assault transporter safe, yeah. Maybe we can even avoid combat. That would be
our warriors will engage the enemy.
Just to make sure that the assault transporter doesn't get shot at first, we have to remove the cloaking device, and the same goes for our colony ship actually. Yeah, so we will try to, well, we cannot get anywhere in one turn, can we? So, we'll be a little outmatched here, but I think we head for the other group, I suppose. That's the best I can come up with the forces at hand. So, 7 transport, this thing is still incoming, because battlecruisers aren't particularly fast right now. We go, so well, we try to fight this, I suppose. So off to the rather unstable combat mode we go. And well, non-combat is pretty wimpy as far as we know, but we cannot tell without a proper ship here to read the stats, I believe. Maybe we can. It's been a while since I last did this here. So, status. We don't have any reliable information apparently. The enemy consists of the ship, well, that's much we already knew. So, I think we try to. For the lighter ships, you want to make use of their mobility, the maneuverability for the most part. Be heavy within the bill. And we can attack them from behind if we want to.
Our weapons stand ready. This fight will be their last.
You will, I'm not quite sure. Yeah, so I will at least improve your defensive odds with something, I suppose.
Yes, sir.
Hopefully we don't get shot to pieces here by this thing.
I had expected more of a fight.
Wow, that was easy, wasn't it? Well, thankfully it was. Could have been a lot of a different story here with the Borg, for instance. Or the Shodak showing up. So we're not sure about the orders, because we don't have a science vessel with us.
Another victory for the Empire!
Terraforming completed.
Yeah, but it was only a minor victory at best. Hopefully didn't abort the starbase construction, but we shouldn't. Sometimes, does though. Okay, so terraforming is completed.
Select terraforming target.
Yeah, we just merged with the other group, that's fine. A good thing we had a couple of forces nearby, right? Because thanks to the random events being enabled, something like this can happen. So still two turns. You know what, guys? I think that's all we need for this session here. That's been a pretty lengthy one anyway.
System will be colonized.
And next time we have a battle to look forward to, assuming I want to take it. And we also need to expand further down here to find out what's going on.
System will be colonized.
And finally make a contact with the Fengi, for instance, so we can start to chop them down. One system at a time, it would also be slow. Also, I'm really looking forward to this. Okay, so every colony... that's fantastic. So we have done all what we wanted to do here for the time being. And otherwise, I think this should be all for now. So as usual, I thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time.